Hibernation is about more than just bears curling up in a den all winter. It can also be this little guy, a fat-tailed dwarf lemur sleeping through the dry season in Madagascar. Hibernation is really a response to hostile environments where food and water are scarce. Think bitter cold winters or super hot summers. If hibernation were just about escaping the cold, you might expect that climate change warming up the earth would mean fewer animals would hibernate. But because hibernation is actually about a lack of food, is there a scenario in which a warmer earth might push animals who didn't hibernate before to start? Hibernating. What is that? Before we figure out if climate change is going to change hibernation, let's get straight what hibernation is. Because hibernation isn't a deep sleep. It's a type of dormancy, where animals go through periods of torpor, also known as decreased activity, interspersed with short awake periods. It usually includes slowed breathing and heart rate, a slowed down metabolism, and decreased body temperatures. There are actually lots of different types of hibernation. The two main types are obligatory and facultative. Obligatory hibernators hibernate on a fixed yearly rhythm.
These guys are the Usain Bolts of hibernation.
That's Sarah Moore. She studies 13-lined ground squirrels, and not only are they adorable, they're also some of those Usain Bolt hibernators she's talking about. They drop their body temperature, metabolic rate, and heart rate way down to go dormant each year, no matter the environmental conditions. Facultative hibernators, on the other hand, only hibernate
when days get shorter and nights get longer, when temperatures get colder, and when food and water become more scarce.
Remember that. That's going to be important later. The crazy thing about hibernation is that it can be due to super cold temperatures or super hot temperatures. Animals might undergo hibernation in cold climates or estivation in warm climates. But no matter when they hibernate, how do animals actually stay in one place, basically without moving, for months without going hungry? I'd be hungry. First things first, fat storage. Lots of hibernating animals build up big fat stores when food is plentiful so that they can use them up when they're hibernating. Fat-tailed dwarf lemurs can hibernate for up to 7 months at a time, so being able to pull energy from big fat stores in their tails is important. This is one of the first ways we might see climate change mess up hibernation. Warmer summers could bring droughts, drying up food sources. That could prevent animals from storing up enough fat to survive their winter hibernations. But hibernating animals can't just rely on a bunch of fat. They also have to regulate their energy levels. If an animal isn't eating much for months on end, they need to dramatically reduce the amount of energy that they're spending, otherwise they'll starve. And that means that they have to slow down their metabolism. Metabolism describes the network of all of the chemical reactions taking place in your cells. This includes breaking molecules from food down to make energy and building new molecules that your cells need. A lot of hibernating animals slow their metabolisms by adding or removing tiny phosphate tags to proteins to turn them on or off. For example, removing these tags from certain carbohydrate munching enzymes turns them off, reducing the speed at which the body breaks down stored carbs and sugars. Many small mammals can save 90% of the energy they would otherwise spend by turning off parts of their metabolic network. And that decreased metabolism drops the animal's body temperature too. But when they need to, an animal can quickly ramp up its metabolism by adding or removing those same phosphate groups to turn proteins back on. While turning metabolism on or off like this might sound like a hibernator superpower, the genes needed for dormancy and hibernation are actually found in many animals, including humans. They're usually genes that we and other animals use for everyday stuff, like fat breakdown, circadian rhythms, and normal homeostasis. But when they're turned on or off in just the right pattern, they can cause hibernation. This means that the potential to hibernate could be right inside the genomes of lots of animals, just waiting to be turned on when the conditions are right. So if all of this has to do with temperature and food availability, will climate change impact how animals hibernate? Yes. Especially the facultative hibernators whose hibernation patterns change based on the environment. And it's already happening. As the winters get warmer, scientists have already seen squirrels and bears emerge from hibernation sooner. This means they might wake up when their food sources just aren't ready yet, or in periods where they have to fight other species for food. Warmer weather in some years has prevented chipmunks from entering hibernation at all. In one study tracking a group of 9 free-ranging chipmunks during a particularly warm year, only one chipmunk entered hibernation. And by the end of the winter, the scientists were pretty sure that all of the rest of them were dead. We can also get a sneak peek at how environmental changes are going to affect hibernators by looking at species that live spread out across multiple habitats. Northern Idaho ground squirrels that live at lower, warmer elevations emerge from hibernation sooner than squirrels who experience deeper snow and later snowmelt at higher elevations. So as temperatures rise across the whole region, all of the squirrels might emerge sooner and sooner.
When it comes to survival of hibernators and probably all animals when it comes to climate change, the question is really, how fast is the change going to happen? How extreme is the change going to be? And how consistent is that change going to be?
But could climate change cause animals that don't currently go dormant to start or to stay dormant longer? Maybe. Over the past 20 years, Colombian ground squirrels living near the Rocky Mountains have actually emerged from their hibernations later and later as late spring snowfalls have become more prevalent due to the changing climate. And adult female survival rate has dropped by 20%. The scientists think it's because the later emergence reduces the amount of time the squirrels have to fatten up before their next hibernation. Paiute ground squirrels have also started to estivate earlier and earlier in the summer due to increased drought. If the summers keep getting hotter, they may keep hibernating for longer and longer. And while dormancy in insects isn't quite the finely tuned homeostatic machine that it is in mammals, dormancy patterns in these tiny organisms might give us some insight into the future. For example, the great banded grayling, a butterfly common to much of Europe that has an amazing name, used to have one main flight peak between June and September. But in more recent hotter summers, scientists see two active flight peaks separated by a period of inactivity. They think that the new inactive period is actually the butterflies going dormant and estivating for 3 to 4 weeks in the driest summer months, waiting it out until cooler temperatures return. This is a new phenomenon in the past 2 decades that correlates with warmer summers. Warmer weather, new hibernation. So, are warmer temperatures going to lead to more animals going dormant in the summer? Maybe. We're not sure yet. But the hotter it gets, the more I'm sure that I'm going to want to take a page out of the Banded Grayling's book and just sleep right on through the summer.